Let's see how we can use a game theoretic approach to analyze a simple market. So we'll look at an example where Annie and Billy are the only two competitors in a certain market, the market being the market for lemonade down a residential street. We'll assume that demand in this market is given by this linear function, so that the most anyone is willing to pay is $7 a glass, and if price was 0.70, glasses would be consumed. For convenience, I've written here a schedule that shows us at different prices what quantity sold in this market, and assuming that marginal cost is constant at 1 for any sellers in the market, how much will be total market profit? You could calculate this yourselves to double check the math. You could also see how if there was a single seller, we could apply the monopoly profit maximizing analysis to this, and we would find that the profit maximizing price is $4. Let's now turn to Annie and Billy. Suppose that their options are to charge either $4 per glass or $3. We'll also need to assume something about how exactly competition happens in this market. So what do consumers respond to when they decide who to buy from? We'll first work with a model where we assume that competition is driven entirely by price, so that customers will consider the two prices and buy whichever lemonade is cheaper. And then that seller will be able to sell to everyone who's interested in buying. So under that assumption, let's first fill out the payoffs in this table. If they each set price at 4, then we see here that they'll sell 30 units total and earn a total profit of 90. Well, under the assumption that they will split the market evenly, that means that each of their profits are 45. What about if Annie charges $3 and Billy charges 4? Well, at $3, there are $80 worth of profit in the market, and Annie would get all of that because no one would be willing to buy at the higher price. So in that case, Annie's profit would be 80, and Billy's would be 0. If, on the other hand, Annie prices at 4 and Billy at 3, then her profit will be 0 and his profit will be 80. And if they both price at 3, then they will simply split that total market profit halfway. One thing we can spot is that if the two children set equal prices, they will both be better off if they set price at 4 rather than at 3. So the question is that the outcome we can expect? In order to solve this game, the first step will be to find the best responses for both Annie and Billy. Let's first put ourselves in Annie's shoes. If Billy prices at 4, then her payoffs would be 45 if she also prices at 4, or 80 if she prices below. So which one is greater? Well, this is greater. And so her best response is to set price at 3. If Billy sets price at 3, then her options are to earn $0 if she sets price above there, or to earn 40 if she also sets price at 3. So this one is greater, meaning that her best response in this case too is to price at $3. That means that pricing at 3 is a dominant strategy for her. Conversely then, pricing at 4 is a dominated strategy. It's never a best response. Next, let's put ourselves in Billy's shoes. So Billy's payoffs are listed second in each cell, and Billy is choosing between which column the outcome will be. So first, Billy might consider, what if Annie sets price at 4? Well, then he has these two options, right, of setting price also at 4 or undercutting Annie's price. Which one is greater? This one is. So his best response for that case is to set price at 3. If Annie sets price at 3, then he'll compare 0 with 40. And then this, again, is his best response. So Billy, too, has a dominant strategy, and that is at of pricing at $3, and the dominated strategy of pricing at 4. If we look now at the game overall, we see that there is only one potential outcome where both players are best responding, and that is this one, where they both price at $3. So that will be our sole Nash equilibrium in this game, is where both Annie and Billy price at $3, and they each earn $40 total profits. This is not the optimal outcome for them. For them jointly, what would be better is if they could both price at 4. However, when considered separately, each of them individually has the incentive to undercut the other one's price, and so the result will be that they both earn lower profits. This is a type of a prisoner's dilemma game. Now, what if we allow for more possible values of price? Annie and Billy now each have 3 possible options for where to set price. First, let's see what Annie's best response is in each of the 3 possible states of the world, so for each possible decision that Billy might take. If Billy priced at $4, Annie's payoffs would be either 45 if she also priced at 4, 80 if she priced at 3, or 50 if she priced at 2. So we'll simply look for the highest number. That's this. That means that her best response when Billy prices at 4 is to price at 3. If Billy sets price at 3, then we'll now compare Annie's payoff as 0, 40, and 50. That means that her best response in that case is to price at 2. And finally, if Billy sets price at 2, then Annie's payoffs will be either 0 or 0 in either of these 2 cases, where she prices above $2, or 25, which is half the market profit if she matches his price at 2. 25 is the greater number. So that means her best response in that case is to match Billy's price at $2. Analyzing her best responses, we could see that Annie doesn't have a dominant strategy. However, she does have a dominated strategy, and that's setting price at 4. In none of these 3 cases is that her best choice. Let's now look at Billy. So Billy will similarly consider each possible state of the world he might face. So he will consider first, what if Annie sets price at 4? Then the payoffs he would be having are 45, 80, or 50. The greatest one is 80, and that's for the case where he sets price at 3. In other words, he wants to undercut her price, but not by too much. If Annie sets price at 3, Billy would be comparing these payoffs, and it looks like his best response in that case is to set price at 2. And finally, if Annie sets price at 2, Billy's best payoff is achieved when he also sets price at 2. So just like Annie, Billy doesn't have a dominant strategy, but he does have a dominated strategy, and that's to price at 4. We could see now that the only Nash equilibrium, the only combination of strategies where both players are best responding, is this one, where they're both pricing at $2. In other words, the only equilibrium is the outcome in which their profit combined is actually minimized. So you could imagine how if they were able to cooperate and set price at 3, or even better at 4, they could each have higher profits. This is just another example of a prisoner's dilemma game, where the 2 players face individually incentives that lead them collectively to the worst outcome. If we added the option of pricing at, let's say, $1.50, we would find that the equilibrium is where they both price at $1.50, and so on. Essentially, we will find that there is no price where they will stop undercutting each other until they get to their marginal cost.